We know more. We have had experience. Also, less hospitalizations per number of infected, less deaths per number of hospitalizations. So we are better there. But still, there's no choice between lives and livelihoods. You have to go hit the virus with all you got, with all the elements that you got, with all the finance that you got. Because that will assure you that you will reduce the economic consequences, the costs. It'll be less onerous. And also, you will reduce the social costs of the pandemic.
How do you sell that to the population, Angel? Look, we've seen protests in Spain, protests that turned violent in major cities in Italy. Regional leaders are refusing to cooperate with central governments and their own national leaders. How do you sell that story?
There is such a thing, and particularly now, as a silent majority that is supporting those measures because they understand that this is important. So I would also not only call on the leaders to be steadfast and to do whatever it takes, but also on the people in the public who support their leaders, who understand the need, which are the broad majority, to come out and express that support.
Angel, we saw a fairly strong response from global leaders initially with the first wave of the pandemic as stimulus from the United States and Europe, but it's been very slow to trickle through the system in Europe. And when it comes to the second stimulus package, it's just not being agreed with all the politics and the backdrop in the United States. Are global leaders dropping the ball now on fiscal stimulus as we battle the second wave of infections?
Not the time to stop the support. Not the time to stop the flexibility of the central banks. They are heroes in this battle, and the same has been the fiscal policy, the response in many of the countries, now they have to continue to do that. It's very unfortunate that after July, for example, in the United States, there's this discussion between the two parties about continuing, because there's a will to actually continue, but they're discussing in the middle of the campaign. In other countries, of course, it has already been announced that support will continue for the whole of 2021, for example, in Germany. And in other cases, they are being extended. This has to be the case. Right now, it's not the time to be looking at the rule book or at the debt to GDP ratios. It's the time to hit the pandemic with everything we have.